声音吗？
紧张啊。
OK， 我们现在可以开始了。
Om Gyanatmarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitanena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shanyavadi Paschacha Deshantarine Pandiham Shri Guru Shri Yata Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajevam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nitamscha Hey Krishna Karana Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastate Tapta Kanchana Gorange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Srivasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So today we're going to speak about the pastime of Lord Krishna, his appearance and his birth, and the first demon who came there to try to kill Lord Krishna.
今天是主 Krishna 显现日，我们会讲一下 Krishna 的逍遥时光，以他的诞生和显现，以及第一个杀死想要去杀死 Krishna 的这个恶魔，最后被 Krishna 杀死了。
So we know Lord Krishna came as the eighth child in the womb of Devaki.
我们知道主 Krishna 是 Devaki 的第八个孩子。
The first six were all killed by the evil King Kamsa.
前面六个孩子都被这个恶魔 Kamsa 给杀害了。
Now it's interesting to understand Kamsa's background.
要了解 Kamsa 的过去是很有意思的一件事情。
Kamsa was born in the Yadu dynasty, just like Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna is also appearing in the Yadu dynasty.
Kamsa 和 Krishna 和主 Krishna 都诞生在亚都王朝。
And the Yadu dynasty were known to be great devotees of Lord Vishnu.
亚都王朝是主 Vishnu 有很多主 Vishnu 的奉献者。
But Kamsa was not a devotee.
但是康萨不是主威士奴的奉献者。
Kamsa was a demon.
康萨是个恶魔。
Now, how did it happen that a demon could be born in the family of so many great devotees and a relation of Lord Krishna?
那么一个恶魔怎么可能投身在这个奉献者的这个王朝里面，而且和主 Krishna 还有一些关系呢？
So Kamsa was actually born in the womb of Padmavati. Padmavati was the aunt of Lord Krishna. She was the wife of Ugrasena.
Kamsa 是 Padmavati 的儿子，而 Padmavati 是 Ugrasena 的妻子。
Haribo，Haribo，Pabo， 请咕噜把视频打开好吗？
不行，我们在印度，我们没有那么多力。如果我们打开我们的照片，我们容易断掉。
好的。
So Kamsa,
Krishna Gurudev, okay.
Kamsa was not actually conceived by Ugrasena. Although he was born in the womb of Padmavati, he was not Ugrasena's son.
Kamsa 虽然是 Padmavati 所生，但是实际上他却不是 Ugrasena 的儿子。
Padmavati actually had been raped by a demon.
Padmavati 事实上被一个恶魔给强奸了。
The demon's name was Drumila.
这个恶魔的名字叫 Drumila.
And he somehow he managed to take advantage of this woman, Padmavati.Who was the wife? Who was the wife of Ugrasena?
这个恶魔趁机占取了 Padmavati, 而 Padmavati 是 Ugrasena 的妻子。
So this is what happens when women give birth in an irreligious manner.
所以这就是以一种非宗教的原则，这个女子怀孕的。
They easily grow up to be demons. The children that they conceive may grow up to be demons.
在这种情况下，怀孕的这个孩子很容易成为一个恶魔。
So Kamsa had a lot of bad association. So many demons also became his associates.
Kamsa 也有很多恶魔的同游，得到了他们的涟漪。
And when he heard that the eighth child of Vasudev and Devaki was going to kill them, going to kill him, then he was ready to kill Devaki.
当 Kamsa 听到第八个孩子将会杀了他时候，他听到这个传言的时候，他准备要去杀了 Devaki.
Devaki was like his sister, but as soon as he heard.That her eighth child was going to kill him, he was ready to kill her.
虽然 Devaki 是他的妹妹，但是当 Kamsa 听到说 Devaki 的第八个孩子会杀了他的时候，他甚至想去杀了 Devaki.
This is the demoniac nature.
这就是恶魔的他的本性。
You can see the difference. Somebody like Dronacharya.Now Dronacharya, he knew that this son of Draupada was born to kill him.
我们可以看一看这其中的一些区别，比如说多纳查亚知道多帕塔的儿子将会杀了他。
Yeah, Draupada performed a sacrifice to get a son.To kill Drona, and that son was Dhrishtadyumna.
Dopata 做了一个祭祀，想要得到一个孩子，能够杀了多纳查亚，这个孩子就是 Dhrishtadyumna.
And Dhrishtadyumna came to become a student of Drona, and Drona accepted him.
而 Dhrishtadyumna 就去找多纳查亚，想拜他为师，多纳查亚竟然还接受了他。
He did not think that, oh, he's going to kill me, I don't want to teach, I'm not going to take him as a student. He didn't think like that. He thought, I'm a brahmana, my duty is to teach.
Dronacharya 并没有想，哦，这个孩子将来会杀了我不能去教他。但是他还是接受了这个孩子。 他认为我是一个婆罗门，我的职责就是教授。
However, Kamsa, he's not a Brahmin. He was born, supposed to be a Kshatriya, but he was a really demonic Kshatriya.
Kamsa, 他不仅不是一个 Brahmana, 他还是一个有恶魔品性的 Kshatriya.
So it happened that after Kamsa killed the first six children, then the seventh child was Lord Balaram.And Lord Balaram was transferred to the womb of Rohini.
当康萨杀了前六个孩子之后，第七个孩子 ，Balaram 是主 Balaram， 主 Balaram 被转移到 Rohini 的子宫之中。
And everyone thought that Devaki had a miscarriage.
每一个人都认为 Devaki 她流产了。
But actually, Yogamaya had transferred, under the orders of Lord Krishna, Yogamaya transferred Lord Balaram from the womb of Devaki to the womb of Rohini.
在主 Krishna 的安排下，命令下， Yogamaya 把主 Balaram 从 Devaki 的子宫转移到 Rohini 的子宫之中。
And Rohini was staying in the home of Nanda Maharaj with Mother Yashoda.
而 Rohini 这个时候，她是在，跟 Nanda Maharaj 那个地方住着。
Lord Balaram had made all arrangements for the appearance of Lord Krishna in the womb of Devaki.
主 Balaram 在 Devaki 的子宫。准备了很多，就是为了主 Krishna 显现，做了很多的准备。
He had left the bed for Lord Krishna.
他甚至为主 Krishna 在 Devaki 的子宫准备了一张床。
That bed was actually Anantashesha, an expansion of Anantashesha.
而这个床实际上是 Anantashesha 的扩展。
So then, after Krishna appears, then Vasudev takes Lord Krishna over to the home of Nanda Maharaj.
当主 Krishna 显现之后， Vasudeva 把主 Krishna 带到 Nanda Maharaj 的家中。
And he takes the girl who is born to Mother Yashoda. He brings that girl back to Kamsa's prison house.
他从 Nanda Maharaj 的家中也带回了一个女儿。带回到这个监狱之中。
We want to understand the identity of this lady, this girl who has been brought from Nanda Maharaj's home, who was the child of Mother Yashoda, who was brought over to Kamsa's jail. Who was she?
我们得了解 Vasudeva 从 Nanda Maharaj 家中带回来的这个女儿，也就是 Yashoda Maharaj 的这个女儿。这个女儿得了解她的身份，她到底是谁。
Some people think she was Subhadra, but no, she is not Subhadra.
有一些人说这个女孩是 Subhadra, 是不是的？她不是 Subhadra.
She is actually Yogamaya.
事实上，他是 Yogamaya。
But there are two kinds of yoga. Yogamaya can take different forms, just like Srila Prabhupada will sometimes refer to Yogamaya as he will sometimes refer to Yogamaya as Mahamaya.
Yogamaya 有很多的形象，就像圣帕帕的有时候会说 Yogamaya， 它实际上指的也可以说是 Mahamaya。
Actually, Mahamaya is synonymous with Yogamaya. It means they have the same meaning.
Yogamaya 和 Mahamaya 有时候是有相同的含义的。
So, Yogamaya cannot be touched by a demon like Kamsa.
Yogamaya 是不可能被像 Kamsa 这样的恶魔给触碰的。
So although Yogamaya appeared as the younger sister of Lord Krishna from the womb of Yashoda, Yogamaya appeared from the womb of Yashoda as the younger sister.
Yogamaya 显现为主 Krishna 的一个妹妹，她也是由这个 Yashoda 母亲所生。
And Vasudev comes and he changes the child. He gives the boy to Yashoda. He takes the girl, and he takes the girl back to the prison house.
Vasudeva 这个时候来了，他带来了一个男孩，然后把这个 Yogamaya 这个女孩给带回到监狱之中。
Now this girl is actually she's not Subhadra. You never see Prabhupada mention the name Subhadra there.But he mentions about how she is Durga. She's like Durga.
这个 Yogamaya 不是 Subhadra. 我们从来没有看到帕帕说这个 Yogamaya 是 Subhadra. 但是帕帕在这提到了这个 Yogamaya 她是 Durga 女神。
There are Subhadras in Krishna Lila, however.
在 Krishna 的逍遥时光中确实有 Subhadra.
There is one Subhadra who was born in the womb also of Rohini, and she was born in Mathura.
有一个 Subhadra, 她确实是出生在 Rohini 的子宫之中，她在 Mathura 诞生。
Later on, she was living in Dwarka with her mother and with Lord Krishna. Everyone had moved from Mathura to Dwarka.So Subhadra was living there in Dwarka.
后来所有人都搬到 Dwarka 去， Subhadra 就和他的父母以及主 Krishna 在 Dwarka 生活着。
And when Arjuna saw her, Arjuna was very attracted to her, and he married her ultimately.
当 Arjuna 看到她之后，也被 Subhadra 所吸引，最后 Arjuna 和 Subhadra 也结了婚。
So, actually, Balaram wanted to marry Subhadra to Duryodhana, but Krishna didn't like it. And Subhadra also, she didn't want to marry Duryodhana. She liked Arjuna.
事实上 ,Balaram 想把 Subhadra 嫁给 Duryodhana, 但是呢 ,Subhadra 不仅不喜欢,主 Krishna 也不喜欢,所以最后这个 Subhadra 还是和 Arjuna 在一起。
So when Vasudev brought the child back to the prison house of Kamsa, Kamsa immediately came. He was going to kill the child, and he wanted to smash the child on the ground.
当 Vasudeva 把这个女孩带回到监狱之中， Kamsa 听到消息之后就立马赶来，想要把这个女孩抓起来就砸向地上。
But instead.This form rose up in the sky and revealed itself to be a deity, a demigod.
当这个女孩正要砸向这个地面的时候，她就已经升到空中，然后展现为一个半身的形体。
And this demigod, Prabhupada explains, is known by many different names and different, sometimes Kali, sometimes Durga. There are many different names for this deity.
圣帕帕德解释到这个形象有时候被称为卡利，有时候被称为杜尔嘎，它有很多很多的名字。
So Subhadra Prabhupada explains the difference. He says there's Durga in the material world and Subhadra is in the spiritual world.
杜尔嘎女神她是在物质世界，而 Subhadra 她是在灵性世界。
They're not the same. And a demon like Kamsa can never touch Subhadra.
像 Kamsa 这样的恶魔，他是无法触碰 Subhadra.
So it happened after the birth of Lord Krishna in the home. Lord Krishna has appeared in the home of Nanda Maharaj. And Nanda Maharaj and his wife, naturally, they're very happy to have a son.
当 主 Krishna 显现在 Nanda Maharaj 的家庭之中，他们 Nanda Maharaj 和 Yashoda 他们非常的开心有这么一个儿子。
They've been trying for a child for a long time, and they were not able to get a child. So when they finally got a child, they were so happy.
他们想要孩子已经很长时间了，因为很长时间没有孩子。当他们有这么一个孩子的时候，他们非常非常的开心。
We can understand they were not very young. They were getting older, and so they were thinking their chances of having a child are not very good.
我们得知道他们年纪已经不小，他们已经有点老了，要一个孩子不是那么的容易。
And an older age to get a son.That's very special because usually, as a woman gets older, she's not going to give birth to a son. It will be a girl.
而在年老的时候，能有一个男，有一个儿子，那就更是很特别了。因为一般的情况下，在年纪比较大的时候，都通常是生的女孩。
So when Nanda Maharaj saw that his wife had delivered such a child, such a beautiful child as Lord Krishna, he was overjoyed.And he immediately began to give charity to the brahmanas.
当 Nanda Maharaj 知道他的妻子生了这么一个漂亮的小孩，一个儿子的时候，他非常非常的愉悦，而且他立即就给这些婆罗门布施。
Just like when Devaki and Vasudev, when the Lord appeared as their child in the prison house of Kamsa,Although they were in the prison house of Kamsa, Vasudev also gave charity, but he had to do it in his mind. He could not actually do it, but he did it in his mind.
就像 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 在狱中生下他们的孩子之后 ，Vasudeva 他也给予了布施。虽然他在狱中，他仍然给予布施。他怎么样做呢？他是通过心意的方式。
Vasudev gave 10,000 cows in his mind in charity to the Brahmins.
Vasudeva 在心意里给予了通过心意的方式给予了 Brahmana 一万头乳牛。
But Nanda Maharaj, he's a Vaishya, and his business is taking care of cows. He has many cows.So when his wife gave birth to a child, he gave 2 million cows in charity.
Nanda Maharaj, 他是一个 Vaishya, 是一个从商的，他的职责就是保护乳牛，而且他还有很多很多的乳牛。当他得知他的妻子生下这个男孩之生下这个孩子的之后，他给了两他布施了两万头乳牛给予婆罗门。
So it was very, very special. Nanda Maharaj gave charity to so many people. Everyone he wanted to give charity.
Nanda Maharaj, 他非常非常的开心，他给予了很多人布施，他遇见人就给予布施。
But he knew, give the brahmanas cows, he knows the brahmanas will take care of the cows. When you give charity, you have to be careful.Who you give charity to, that they can use it properly.
当我们给予布施的时候，我们也得小心，因为 Nanda Maharaj 他给予乳牛，布施把奶牛布施给婆罗门，因为他知道婆罗门会保护奶牛，所以我们在布施的时候，我们也得小心，我们要把我们的布施给予谁。
If you give cows to someone and then they sell the cows or have the cows killed, then it's very bad.
如果我们把奶牛、把乳牛布施给一些人，他却把这个奶牛给卖了，或者说把这个奶牛给杀了，这是非常非常不好的。
So Nanda Maharaj was very happy. His wife has got a son, and of course he doesn't know that this child was actually exchanged with Vasudev's child. He's not aware of this. Neither is Mother Yashoda.
Vasudeva 和 Nanda Maharaj 他们都Vasudeva 这个 Yashoda 和这个 Nanda Maharaj 他们都非常的开心，他们甚至都没有注意到自己的孩子被换了。
So it happened after a few days, Vasudev had, rather Nanda Maharaj had to go to Mathura to take care of some, paying some taxes to the government or so on. And Mother Yashoda was left with the other ladies in Gokul with their children.
在一些天之后 ,Nanda Maharaj 去到了 Mathura 去付一些税，而亚修达母亲和一些其他的女士则留在了狗窟了。
It happened that Kamsa had been told by Narada Muni that the demigods are all taking birth in the Yadu dynasty.
Narada Muni 还跟 Kamsa 说，这些半世人都投身在了亚杜王朝。
Kamsa then arranged for his different demonic friends that they should go and kill all the young children born in the area.
于是 Kamsa 就安排了他那些恶魔的朋友去屠杀那片区域的所有的年轻的小孩。
One of the friends of Kamsa was the evil witch Putana.
Kamsa 的一个恶魔朋友名字叫 Putana.
And Putana, well, she's from a family of demons. She has a brother called Baka, and I think also Aga is also a brother. Two brothers, both big demons.
Putana 也是来自于恶魔家庭，他的两个兄弟 Baka 和 Aga， 他们都是大恶魔。
So Putana was also a very powerful witch, and she had killed many small children.
Putana 也是一个非常有力量的女巫，她杀了很多的小婴儿。
Now these demons are very powerful; they can change their form, and this Putana could change. Sometimes she would take the form of a bird, and she could fly into places.
这些恶魔他们这个恶魔普塔纳他非常的有力量，甚至都可以改变自己的形象，他变成一只小鸟都可以在空中飞行。
普塔纳 flew into Gokul and then she changed her form to assume the form of a very beautiful, very attractive gopi.
普塔纳飞到了狗窟了，通过她的力量，她变成了一个非常非常美丽的女士。
She was very attractive. She had beautiful feet, facial. Her face was very beautiful, and she was well, very nicely dressed, and she had a beautiful figure with big breasts and a very thin waist.
她变成了一个非常美丽、非常有吸引力的女士，脸长得很漂亮。胸部非常的饱满，臀部也非常的饱满，反正就是很漂亮。
And all the coward men in Gokul, Nanda Maharaj's friends, the coward men, when they saw her, they were all attracted. They thought, oh, what a very good-looking woman. Who is she?
Nanda Maharaj 的这些朋友，这些木牛郎们看到了这个 Putana， 他都被他吸引了。Oh, 她的长相实在是太好看了，太具有吸引力了。
And Mother Yashoda and Rohini, they were also thinking, who is this? Where did she come from? So they asked her, who are you? Where are you from?
Yashoda 和 Rohini 母亲看到了她，也被她吸引，甚至这两个母亲都上前去问她，你是谁？你从哪里来？
And she told them, she's very cunning, she's a very clever woman, she's this Putana, she's a witch, she's really smart. So she said to them, oh, I'm the wife of a Brahmin from Mathura.
这个女巫非常的聪明，她说，我是从 Mathura 来的一个婆罗门的妻子。
I've come to give blessings to the newborn child.
我来给予这个新出生的婴儿以好运，给他祝福。
So the ladies thought, Mother Yashoda and Rohini, they thought, oh, so nice. You know, this was not the influence of Mahamaya, this was Yogamaya. to arrange the pastime.
当 Rohini 和 Yashodama 听到这一些之后，他觉得哦，非常的好，而这一切实际上都是 Yoga Maya 在从中安排着。
It was not Mahamaya.
他们并没有受到 Mahamaya 的影响。
It was the arrangement of Lord Krishna for his pastime.
这是主 Krishna 为他的逍遥时光所做出的安排。
One of Krishna's pastimes is to kill the demon.
主 Krishna 的逍遥时光的一部分是为了杀恶魔。
So Putana was thinking she was coming to kill the child, but actually it was going to be her own death.
Putana 认为自己是来杀小孩的，但是事实上这却造成了她自己的死亡。
So Putana came forward and everyone just allowed her to come and pick up the child. And she picked up the child and then she saw the child. When she saw Krishna, she could understand, oh, this child is very powerful.
Putana 于是就上前把这个小孩抱了起来。当他抱起这个小孩的时候，他看到这个小孩，他当时就感觉到，哇，这个小孩太有力量了。
So Krishna could understand she was hesitating a bit.So Krishna closed his eyes so that she would feel more confident.
主 Krishna 知道这个女巫有点犹豫，于是主 Krishna 把眼睛闭起来，让这个 Putana 有点自信。
Other reasons why Krishna closed his eyes were he did not like the idea. It's not very proper to kill a woman.
主 Krishna 闭上眼睛的第二个理由是要杀害他觉得要杀一个女士不是一个特别好的主意。
In the Vedic culture, women should never be killed, they should be protected.
在伟大的文化中，女人不应该被杀害，应该总是受到保护。
Just like cows, and brahmanas, children, they're not to be killed.
就像还有乳牛、婆罗门、小孩、女人，他们都应该受到保护，而不应该受到杀害。
But this woman Putana was a very evil woman. She had killed many, many young children.
但是这个 Putana 她是一个非常非常的邪恶的人，她杀了很多很多的小孩。
So Krishna did not like to look on her face. That's another reason why he closed his eyes.
所以主 Krishna 甚至都不想去看这个邪恶的人一眼，这也就是 Krishna 在开始的时候闭上眼睛的第三个原因。
So Putana comes and gives her breast to Lord Krishna, and Lord Krishna took her breast and squeezed it tightly, and she screamed, "Oh, child, leave me, leave me!"
于是 Putana 就把自己的乳汁。给予乳房给予这个主 Krishna 给他去吸引，主 Krishna 紧紧的抓住这个乳汁吸引非常紧，然后这个 Putana 就开始叫起来了，哦，请放开我，放开我。
And Lord Krishna not only took out her milk, but he also took out her life air.
主 Krishna 不仅吸取了他的乳汁，而且还吸取了他的生命之气。
And when Lord Krishna had squeezed her breast so tightly, Putana had screamed and she rushed out of the house. She rushed out of Nanda Maharaj's house, out into the outside. And she was in such a difficult, in so much pain,that she had to reveal her original form as a Rakshasi, as a demon.
当主 Krishna 紧紧地抓住她的乳房开始吸吮的时候，这个 Putana 当时不仅大叫，而且 跌倒着跌倒着就跌倒出了 Nanda Maharaj 的房中，到外面的这个 院子之中还有一点远，之后他就显现出他原本的恶魔的 Rakshas 的这个形体。
And that original form of Putana was actually 12 miles long.
这个 Putana 原本的形体甚至有12英里这么长。
So she fell on the ground. The people in Vrindavan and Gokul, they'd been shocked when she screamed. But when she revealed her original form, they were just overwhelmed. They were just completely amazed.
当这个普塔纳大叫的时候，已经把当地的居民给吓到了。当这个普塔纳展现出他原本的这个形体有十二英里这么长的时候，当地的这些文达门的居民甚至都震惊了。
So Mother Yashoda, she's anxious. Where's my child? And she's looking for her child everywhere. And finally, she sees him. He's on the He's still on the breast of Putana. Lord, she's laying on the ground dead. Lord Krishna's crawling on her breast.
这个时候，亚修达妈妈就开始焦虑的，我的孩子到底在哪里呢？当她找啊找啊，就发现这个 Putana 倒在了外面的地上，而她的儿子 Krishna 还在吸吮的 Putana 的乳房。
Now we want to understand.Who is this Putana?
我们需要理解，到底这个 Putana 是谁呢？
That somehow she was able to come in to Nanda Maharaj's house and pick up Krishna and give her breast to Krishna.
由于不知怎的，她就能到 Nanda Maharaj 的家中抱起了 Krishna， 甚至给Krishna 哺乳。
Now that's not an art to be able to do that kind of thing, to come in and actually pick up Lord Krishna in your arms and offer your breast to Krishna. You have to have some very special qualification to do that.
你要把 Krishna 举起来抱在你的怀里，甚至把你的乳汁供奉给他，这都是需要很特别的品质才行的。
And even though she's coming to kill Krishna, her intention is evil, but Lord Krishna is so kind, he accepts her and he kills her, but he liberated her.
即便她的目的和动机是为了杀死主 Krishna, 主 Krishna 甚至接受了她，而虽然杀死了她，但是她接受了她，而且还给予了她解脱。
Yeah, there's a beautiful verse stated in the third canto, second chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, where Uddhava is describing the mercy of Lord Krishna.
在瓦坦的第三篇的第二章，Uddhava 在讲述主 Krishna 的仁慈的时候，有这么一个诗节。
Aho bhakiyam stanakala kutam.Jagam saya payanad apya sadvi. Like Uddhava is describing, who could be more merciful than Lord Krishna?
Uddhava 说，有谁能比主 Krishna 更加的仁慈呢？
He's so merciful that this Putana came to poison him, but Lord Krishna took her to the spiritual world to be his nurse in the spiritual world.
这个 Putana 在他的乳汁上下毒，想要毒死主 Krishna， 但是主 Krishna 接受了他，甚至给予了他解脱，让他在灵性世界作为一名护士。
Although Putana was so evil-minded that she came with the intention of killing Krishna,Krishna liberated her and took her back. He thought, she wants to be my mother. She wants to be my nurse. Let her go back to Godhead.
这个恶魔的普塔纳，他虽然怀着恶魔的动机，但是主 Krishna 接受了他。他说：“哦，他竟然想当我的母亲，想给予我喂奶，我接受了他，而且让他成为了在灵性世界主 Krishna 的奶妈。”
Yeah, he saw that she really wants to be like us. She wants to be like Mother Yashoda. She had dressed up just like a gopi.
主 Krishna 看见了，他非常想成为我们中的一员。他非常，他甚至穿的打扮的非常好，就像一个牧牛姑娘一样。
Just like Mother Yashoda, she was dressed up like a, just like a gopi.
他打扮的非常好，就像一个牧牛姑娘一样。他想像亚修达一样。
Therefore, she got.The same destination as Mother Yashoda is going to get.
最终她得到了和亚修达母亲一样的地位。
She doesn't just go to Vaikuntha, she goes to Goloka.
她不仅她不是去到 Vaikuntha, 她去到的是 Goloka.
At the same time, we should understand, she doesn't have the prema bhakti like Mother Yashoda.
但与此同时，我们也得了解，她并不是和她并没有像亚修达妈妈那样有纯粹的 bhakti prema bhakti。
She is going to be a nurse in the spiritual world, but she will be a little distant.Because she doesn't have the same kind, she's not a prema bhakti. She's not a prema bhakti.
她去到的，她在灵性世界成为主 Krishna 的一个奶妈。但是呢，她虽然回到灵性世界，但是和 Krishna 还是有一点距离的，因为她没有这个完全纯粹的奉爱。她不是一个完全纯粹奉爱的奉献。
Her mood, Putana's mood, is worshipping Krishna with some reverence, and at the same time, happiness.
Putana 的心态是有一些富裕去崇拜主 Krishna, 同时有一些快乐。
So we can understand.If somebody offers something to Krishna with love, with real love, they'll get even a better result than Putana.
我们要了解的是，如果一个人怀着真正的爱服务 Krishna 的话，他会得到比 Putana 更好的位置。
Just like the cows in Vrindavan, Lord Krishna would also drink the milk from the cows in Vrindavan.
就像文达文的奶牛，他同这些母牛也给主 Krishna 喂奶。
So they get a better position than Putana.
他们得到的位置要比 Putana 还要好。
And when Lord Brahma stole away the cows and the cowherd boys, Lord Krishna took the place of all the cows and the cowherd boys.
当主 Brahma 偷走了这些奶牛和牧牛童的那个小儿时光的时候，主 Krishna 甚至替换了这些奶牛和牧牛童。
And at that,
亲自
行。At that time, Krishna could drink the breast milk of all the ladies in Vrindavan, all the mothers of the cowherd boys. They would feed their breast milk to Krishna.
这样主 Krishna 就可以喝到。所有文达们这些牧牛姑娘们的乳汁。
Oh, I don't think that's quite. They may have funny one time. Funny,
oh, okay,
people find.
Sorry, Lord Krishna, can drink all the Vrindavan's.
Yeah, when Lord Krishna took the place of all the cowherd boys, and the cows.Brahma stole away the cows and the cowherd
yes, yes.
boys, so Brahma, Lord Krishna took their place.
当主 Brahma 偷走了这些牧牛童和奶牛的时候，主 Krishna 亲自就是说代替了他们。
So that time, Krishna would go to the homes of the cowherd boys disguised just like the cowherd boy. Krishna would go.
这样主
yeah. You got it.
这样主 Krishna 就可以因为主 Krishna 当时就代替了这些牧牛童和小奶牛，所以主 Krishna 代替为成这些小牧牛童的时候，他回到这些家中，他可以吃他们的乳汁。
But the ladies, they didn't know this is not my son. They thought this is my son, but actually it was Krishna.
但是这些文达们的牧牛姑娘们，就是这些妈妈们，她们并不知道哦，这个就是我。他们认为这个确实就是我的儿子，但是实际上他们不知道这个儿子实际上是主 Krishna 本人。
So all these ladies, all these cows, they were feeding the milk to Krishna. They all get a very high place in the spiritual world.
所以所有的这些文达们的这些女士给予 Krishna 哺乳，还有这些。奶牛给予 Krishna 哺乳，他们都在灵性世界得到更好的位置。
Putana, she was, you know, she was just pretending to be a gopi.
Putana, 她只是假扮成为一个牧牛姑娘。
But Krishna saw, oh, she wants to be my mother. She wants to feed me.
但是 Krishna 想，哦。他竟然想成为一个牧牛姑娘，他想成为我的母亲，他想给我喂奶。
So one of the Shastras describe that in the Bali Maharaj had one daughter. The daughter of Bali Maharaj was named Ratnamala.
在一个经典里面说，巴利马哈拉吉有个女儿叫 Ratnamala。
So this daughter of Bali Maharaj, when Lord Vamanadev appeared, when Bali Maharaj was doing the yagya, Lord Vamanadev appeared, and she was attracted to Lord Vamanadev.
当 Bali Maharaj 在做这个祭祀的时候，主 Vamanadev 出现了，而 Bali Maharaj 的这个女儿就被主 Vamanadev 所深深的吸引。
And she thought, oh, I would like to have a child like that.
这个女儿，这个巴利马哈拉吉的女儿就想，哦，我真的想要一个和主巴曼拉戴夫一样的这样的一个孩子。
She thought, if I have a child like that, I can feed him my breast milk.
我如果能有像巴曼拉戴夫这样一样的这个孩子，我就可以给他喂奶了。
But then she saw Vamanadev trick her father and take away all the kingdom of her father.
但是他后来又看见了主 Vamanadev 做了一个小技巧，把他父亲所有的土地全都夺走了。
So she thought, yes, I will feed him my breast milk and I put poison on my breast to kill him.
所以那个时候这个巴利马哈拉吉的女儿就想，我要给他喂奶，但是我要在我的乳头上涂上这个毒液，要毒这个小孩。
So she got both her desires.
所以她得到了她的两个愿望都满足了。
She got to pick up Lord Krishna and she got to offer her poisoned breast to him.
她把主 Krishna 抱在怀里，然后向他供奉有毒的奶汁。
So Putana represents the evil teacher, the teacher who wants to deceive people.
这个 Putana 代表了是恶魔的老师，恶魔般的老师。这些恶魔般老师就是他想毒害人们。
And we see how she appeared as soon as Lord Krishna appeared. She's the first demon to come.
她是来杀主 Krishna 的第一个恶魔。
There are many other demons. with many other motives, but she was the first one to come.
有很多其他的恶魔带着他们不同的动机，但是这个 Putana 是来杀 Krishna 的，是第一个。
But Lord Krishna killed her.At the same time, he liberated her, took her back to Godhead. He gave her his greatest mercy.
这个 Putana 想来杀主 Krishna, 但是主 Krishna, 杀了这个 Putana, 然后还给予他解脱，给予他最大的仁慈。
But we should understand the responsibility in presenting Krishna consciousness.
我们要理解的是在呈现主 Krishna 知觉的这种责任。
That we have to present the philosophy very carefully and in a very authorized manner.
我们应该以一种非常小心和权威的方式呈现这个哲学。
Sukadeva Goswami in the beginning of the 10th canto describes the qualification for discussing the pastimes of Krishna.
Sukadeva Goswami 在瓦坛的第十篇给我们讲述了在呈现主 Krishna 逍遥时光之前的这些品应该所具有的品质。
He says, Nivritta Tashyeru Pagiyamanat Bavo Bavo Manat Shotra Like, he said, Nivritta Tashyeru, he said, one has to be without material desire.
一个人在呈现的时候应该是没有物质的欲望。
We have to present the teachings as it is received from the acharyas.
我们应该从 acharya 那里接受到什么就传递给什么，从先前的 acharya 那里接受到的信息然后再传递出去。
And if we have any material motive in presenting that, then the message will not be effective.
如果我们在传递的过程中带着个人的动机的话，不会有效果的。
So the message of Krishna consciousness is so, fragile that a little mishandling and the whole message can be ruined.
Krishna 知觉的这个知识，如果有一丁点的掺杂在这个里面，或者说。有个人的东西掺杂在里面，所有东西都会出现问题。
We often give the example about the mango fruit.
我们经常给予这个类比说芒果。
Now mango fruit is very delicious, but it's also very delicate. It's easily damaged.
Mango 非常的美味，但是它也容易坏。
容易破了。
容易破了，对。
So it has to be handled from branch to branch very carefully. We have to bring it down from the tree, pass it down without throwing it. You can other fruits like apples, you can just throw them down, but not the mango.
我们在这个摘芒果的时候，得手把手的一个接一个的从树上摘下来。然后小心地放好，而不是去扔它，因为它非常的美味，但是很容易破。但是芒果不像其他的苹果，你可以扔，或者怎样。但是芒果我们得非常小心地传递这个芒果。
So we want to,
摘这个芒果。
So we want to very carefully present this Krishna conscious philosophy as it's according to Sadhu, Shastra, and Guru.
同样的道理，我们在呈现 Krishna 知觉的这门讯息的时候，同样依照萨度经典圣人和灵性导师，依照他们的原样去呈现这个 Krishna 知觉。
Okay, so are there any questions here today? Maybe a quick question.
Today they said, because time is very short, so they
no questions.、Huh?
Yeah.Yes, yes.
Okay. All right. So, what should I say? So afterwards, Nanda Maharaj, he'd gone off to Mathura, But he was told by Vasudev, you should get back quickly to Gokul, because I worry that there may be some danger there. So you should be there to make sure everything is safe.
Nanda Maharaj 去到的Mathura, 但是 Vasudeva 告诉他，你得非常小心。我觉得有一些不好的事情可能就会发生，你得非常小心，赶紧回到Gokula，保证一切的安全。
So Nanda Maharaj, he's a very simple man. He's just a farmer, simple. But Vasudeva was much more educated, and so he took Vasudeva's advice and he came back to Gokul.
Nanda Maharaj 是一个比较简单的人，而 Vasudeva 他又比较受过很好的教育，他非常的谨慎和小心，所以 Nanda Maharaj 接受了 Vasudeva 的建议，赶紧回到了 Gokul。
And when he came back to Gokul, he was surprised to see this huge body of Putana, 12 miles long, laying on the ground.
当他回到 Gokula, 他发现这个有12英里长的这个 Putana 的躯体躺在地上的时候，他非常非常的吃惊。
And he was wondering, how could this be? How this big, gigantic form, where did it come from?
他非常吃惊，到底这么一个大的这个躯体是从哪里来的呢？
So when he heard what had happened, then he was really surprised and he was very happy that Lord Krishna was safe and nobody was harmed.
当他听到所发生的这一切的时候，他既惊讶也非常开心，因为所有主 Krishna 以及所有的人都没有受到大的伤害。
So it was arranged thatYou know, because this woman was such a demon, they understood that they have to dispose of her body. So they had her off, they had her body cut into pieces and burned.
他们都非常知道这是一个恶魔的躯体之后，他们于是就把这个躯体给切成了几半，然后把它给焚烧了。
Srila Prabhupada explains, he said, when you kill something like a poison snake or something,He said, then you don't just kill it and leave it, because it may come back to life.
Srila Prabhupada 讲，在你们在我们在杀害我们在比如说杀掉这些恶魔的，比如说蛇的时候，我们把它杀了之后，我们不是说杀了之后马上就离开，我们要把它切了，然后把它给烧了，因为它有可能马上就又活过来。
And if it comes back to life, it will come and get the person who tried to kill it.
因为这个蛇如果再恢复过来的话，它有可能就又去找这个杀它的人的麻烦。
So Nanda Maharaj and all the people of Gokul, they arranged to have the body of Putana cut up and burned. And when they burned the body, it gave a beautiful smell.
当Nanda Maharaj 和当地的这些居民们把这个 Putana 躯体切成了几半，然后焚烧了之后，那个焚烧出来的这个味道非常的香。
Yeah, there's a special perfume which they have called Anguru, and this is very beautiful, very attractive aroma. But when they burned Putana's body, it smelled even better than this Anguru.
有一种木头应该是属于沉香，叫阿古鲁。这个阿古鲁出现的这个味道非常非常的香，但是这个普塔纳的尸体焚烧出来的香味，甚至比这个阿古鲁的味道还要好。
So this is due to Lord Krishna biting Putana and injecting his purification into the body of Putana.That she became very nice smelling.
这就是主 Krishna 的特别的仁慈，因为他咬了 Putana 的躯体，然后 Putana 的躯体得到了特别的净化的这个结果。
Previously, you know, she was an ugly Rakshasi, with a horrible smell because she'd been killing so many children.
在之前，她是一个。非常邪恶丑陋的，而且一个恶魔 Rakshas， 因为他而且闻起来也特别的臭味，因为他杀了很多的小孩，有很多的罪恶。
But by the mercy of Krishna, now her body was giving such a beautiful smell.
由于主 Krishna 的仁慈，她的躯体现在有非常美味的香味。
All right, so this one hour is up. This is the end of our class, right?
Yes.
So thank you very much, Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Sri Krishna Janmashtami Mahotsava ki.
Jai.
Sri Krishna Avirbhav Mahotsava Ki
Jai
Gaur Premanande
Ganshin
Niman Lingting Jufuni Chira Kwaila
Hare Krishna Maharaji
Hare Krishna Prabhu